La saba shakato bash. Zimaya bayanda shata. Rika po zinda hurias. Losi kabama shanda. Rika pa bradosh. Lima sanda kope lazanandosh. The unquenchable longing. Let me tell you one of the levels of the spirit. One of the greatest level of the spirit. No matter how you pray, no matter how you speak in tongues, no matter what people talk about you, or no matter how you cast out demons, you manifest power in a great way. Let me show you one of the highest levels of the realm of the spirit. Any moment any child of God attains this level, then you are in for something bigger. That you raise your hands and people are falling under anointing, that is a lower level of glory. That you speak in tongues is not enough. I want to show you one of the highest level of the spirit. I want to lead you to a dimension. Maybe when you close your eyes, you see revelations. That is not bad. Or you are full of prophecy. Or there is this gift you have that people sought after you for it. It is good. But I want to show you one of the highest level of manifestation. One of the highest level of the glory of God. Whenever you attend this level, then you know that you are grounded in God. We don't know men that are grounded in God because they pray or because you come to church. No, we don't know you that you have foundation when you know that is a level I want to bring you us to. That is a dimension I want to introduce us into. That whenever you get to that dimension, the moment you begin to discover the particles and the reality of this dimension around you, then know you are in for something bigger. There is a level of God that when you get to it, then we can trust you. You didn't hear me? There is a dimension of God, there's a level in the ministry that the moment you attend that level, everybody will just trust you. I can trust you. God can trust you. What is that level? Whenever a child of God gets to the level where he cannot substitute, where he cannot exchange the presence of God for anything. Whenever you come to that dimension where you cannot exchange God for anything, no matter what it is, no matter the pressure, whenever you come to the realm where nothing can push you, nobody can talk you out of what you know about God, then you have entered the cruising dimension of the Almighty. Then we can trust you. Then God can trust. God knew Job. Job was a richer man. He was rich in the East and greatest in the East. But the moment Job got to that dimension where I highly esteem you. I esteem you, the word of God, more than everything around me. I esteem you. I prefer you. The moment Job came to that dimension, God told Satan, you see that one, I trust him. Because he have come to the realm where he cannot exchange me for anything. Not even for any treasure. Nothing. Jesus was such a one. That because Jesus came to that dimension, devil promised him the glory. Devil promised him the earth. Devil promised to give him anything he can think of. But Jesus said, never. Because I have come to this dimension, I cannot exchange what I carry, what I know. I can't exchange my glory. I can't exchange what I have with what you want to bring to me. Whenever a child of God comes to that realm where nothing else can move you, no matter what people give you, no matter the gift you receive from men, you cannot change your stand of God. The moment you come to that dimension, then know that you are in for a spectacular happening. That something is about to begin. There is an eruption. There is a dimension. There is a capacity. that is a miraculous development about to happen in you, then know that heaven, you are not too far from heaven. The moment you cannot exchange the treasures of this life, the moment you can't exchange woman, you can't exchange words, you can't exchange dollar, you can't exchange euro or pound sterling for the presence of God, no matter how much a man offer you, no matter how much they offer you in the office, you prefer the presence of the Almighty. The moment you come to that dimension, the moment you grow to that extent where you cannot trade God's presence for money, then you are not too far from the kingdom. Many Christians today grew up. They didn't develop to this extent, but because they saw themselves manifesting power, and because they saw themselves in offices they are not qualified, and because lack of personnel brought them to some certain influence, because they repented and then begin to enjoy some privileges, they did not allow the making process, they did not allow the grace of God to bring them to the dimension of this grace where you cannot exchange God for anything. They didn't allow God to bring them to this level because they just saw that they are progressing, and then they didn't give it thought. They never prayed and asked God to lead them to that place of protection and assurance. Today, many of them have fallen. Many have left God because of dollar. Many of them have forsaken the faith of our fathers. Many of them have left Calvary. We are Jesus, the message at Calvary. Many people have left that message of Calvary. Many have traded their faith. Many have traded their holy beginning, their humble beginning. Many have sold their morality to Satan. Because of words, because of condition, many have backslided. Because they didn't allow God to carry them to that level where they cannot hunger for any other food except God. Let me tell you, until God develops a hunger in you, until God causes a hunger in you, until something develops in you, until a hunger develops in you, that hunger that only God can solve, until you begin to have that longing in your spirit, the longing that only God can quench, then you are far from the kingdom. If the hunger you have now can be quenched when they settle you, hear me, when they call you in the office and settle you and then give you one post or one position or give you one or two things and then they calm you down, you are just a spiritual sycophant. Let me tell you, if the hunger you have, if this longing you carry in your spirit can be quenched by dollar or by settlement, when they call you and settle you, your problem is that they have not settled me. I have suffered in this ministry. I have suffered in this church. I have suffered in this community. And they have not settled me. Nobody wants to give me anything. Because of that, I will make their government unrelable. And you are looking for settlement. If the longing in your spirit, if the passion you have can be settled by office, can be settled by money, can be settled by appointments, then you are a spiritual sycophant. You don't have part. You do not have future in the kingdom. Until you have that longing, until you have that desire in you that is unquenchable, then you are not far from the kingdom. God is raising men and women all over the globe, men that cannot be easily bought over, men that cannot easily leave what they have, men that are not easily buffeted by the winds of the present century generational wind, men that are not easily moved by Yahoo guys, men that cannot trade their soul because of Venza, men that cannot trade their spirit because of Bugatti, men that cannot trade their soul because of one mansion, because of money. You are not moved. Treasures of the world combined together cannot shake your faith. There is a man God is raising in this era, men that will stand for what they believe. Men that not even marriage, no woman on earth, no condition of time can push them out of what they have known. This faith of our father, men, God is raising men that nothing can buy them over, nothing can silence them, not even an office, not a political office can silence the hunger in your spirit. Let me tell you, if the hunger you carry can be quenched by intimidation. When they threaten you, then you subdue. If this hunger to worship God in you arose as a result of hardship, you do business in no work, you put out here in no work, and yet you desire, maybe God is calling me. If it is treasure, if it is desire, if it is money, if it is a loss of the eyes that prompted the desire, this hunger in you now, let me tell you, if the desire you have in you is initiated, was initiated by money, because you saw one pastor riding vehicle, you saw one pastor counting money, dashing at dollars, dashing at motor, and because of that, you developed a hunger in you, you cannot last. God is raising men that have a hunger that nothing can quench. I pray that prayer almost every day. I say, oh my Father, create in me this hunger that only you can quench. A hunger that shawarma cannot quench. Not even an outing. Somebody took you and bought you things and bought you clothes. And then clothes made you lose the hunger you have. The hunger of the presence of the Lord. This morning I am speaking on unquenchable longing. The unquenchable longing. The unquenchable longing. The desire you have that cannot be bought over. That's the desire you have that money cannot quench. The desire to worship God. When you have this longing in your spirit, nobody can talk you out of it. When you believe God, not because of good things, not because of treasure. When you are serving God, not because of money, then nothing can shake you. Why people collapse today? Why we have many fed missionaries? Why we have so many fed church members? Why we have pastors that do not succeed in ministry? They can be succeeding physically. You see them looking good physically, but spiritually they are decayed. They have lost the stand. Why do we have so many churches in Nigeria and yet people are not repenting? Why do we have churches in Nigeria everywhere, yet souls are dying every day? Why do we have churches, plenty of them, yet people are going to hell? We have too many churches because these churches were raised up out of physical desire. Men want to make an ends meet. Bible said their belly, their stomach is their God. Let me tell you, if your stomach prompted the desire, if this longing I see in your spirit, if the reason why you come to church was because of stomach, you want to get a position, you want to come into an office where you count money, where people applaud you and they give you gift. If this longing in your spirit was prompted by desire of money, prompted by stomach ministry, you are far from the desire. You are far from the kingdom. God is raising certain men and women that cannot be moved by money. Men that are not moved by conditions. Not even what you are passing through can shift you. Hey, men that work as though Satan doesn't exist. Men that tread upon this earth unshaken. Men that no matter what they pass through, they remain sacrosanct. These are men I'm talking about. God is raising. Rakabo Shagaya. Zegedegede. Not that you are a pastor. The moment they suspended you and took away the post from you, you stop coming to church. That hunger in you is a fake one. Any hunger in you prompted, sustained by position. Hear me. If this hunger in you is supported by, it is position prepared, because you are still a GS, because you are still an superintendent, you are still a president of the youth, you are still a leader, you are still a worker, you are still a choir member, because it is the post that is propelling you. If you don't come to church, let me give you an example. If whenever you miss church and people come to you because they say your position is lacking, we didn't see in the choir today, then that longing is not of God. It's a fleshy longing. Men should not miss you because of position. Men should miss you because of the hunger you have for God. There is this hunger you have for God that money cannot quench. These are men God is raising in this dispensation, men that will stand upon the flood and they will stand their head under water and yet they are breathing fine. Men that circumstances cannot shake. Let me tell you, many pastors today, many children of God today have compromised their faith because of what they are going through. Many of them have sold their soul of late to Satan because they met God and they wanted God to give them dollar. They met God, wanted that God will open. Before 2 months, they will have cars. And then after 5 years of ministry, there is no car coming on their side. After many years of churchism, they are not getting any money. Because of that, they thought it twice. They say, are you sure this thing is not a scam? I am speaking revival this morning. This is the voice of revival. Malachi say, oh Lord, rise with a healing, the wings of healing. Then Micah say, revive your work, oh Lord, in the midst of the year. There is a hunger in your spirit. There is a longing in your stomach that money cannot quench. Let me tell you, if money can quench your vision, if money can be able to change your stand, then you are far from the kingdom. The kingdom remnants are those that nothing can change their stand, not even money. Nobody can talk them out of the vision of God. No one, even if you lie, give them duplex. If you lie, give them 100 cars. Begin to pay them every month. They cannot be placed on salary because the longing they have in them is more than what you can give them. I don't know who desires this longing this morning. Unquenchable desire, unquenchable aspiration. This thing that cannot be quenched in a hurry. I don't know who wants God to initiate this longing in my spirit. You say, Lord, I long for you. As the deer pants after the water brooks, so my soul longs for you. Forever and ever, yes, my heart beats for you. Men that have their heart beating for God. I don't know who is making that sincere plea this morning. Say, Lord, in me, grant me the desire that cannot be quenched. Let me tell you a story. There was a brother in the church. I will not mention the church or the name for purposes, security purposes and copyright. The brother, a prayer warrior brother, he repented, have the zeal of God in him. And because of that zeal, he joined the prayer band. If you see him praying, when he start praying, he followed God to a dimension that God was everything about him. This prayer warrior brother, so prayerful, but something happened in his life. One circumstance struck him. He lost so many business. Between in a twinkle of an eye, he lost everything he garnered for years. There was no longer money around him. People hated him. Though he was a prayer warrior, but evil befell him. He lost so many things on the way. Then one day the brother carried the Bible. He kept the Bible. He said to God, I serve and pray, and you allow me to pass this condition. You allow me to lose everything I have labored for. He said, from today, I will not serve you again. He denounced his commitment with God. He denounced everything. He said, I no serve again. I no pray again. I no go to church again. Then what he did, he took the last money he had, he went to a hotel. I hired a room and paid for a room in the hotel and then paid for a prostitute. He said, give me one. I want to commit this in this night. Give me one girl this night. So he paid for a sex worker, paid for a hotel room, because in his life, inside him, God offended him. So he denounced his lordship. He denounced his followership of God and then took his last money and went to a hotel, hired a room in the hotel and then paid. And that night, he lodged with that sex worker. So he was on the bed. The woman went and took her bed and put on towel and was waiting for him. So the brother was standing somewhere. That same night, in the other room, there were three brothers that came to have a vigil in the other room, in the same hotel. Three brothers, prayer warrior brothers, came to have vigil in the other room. So as this brother, this retired prayer warrior was here, the prostitute was waiting for him on the bed. I said, Olga, come now, let's do, the time is going. Now, what happened? The other three brothers that came for Virgin were there. By the time the brother wanted to remove his clothes, the other three brothers began to pray. They came for a tarry night, and they were speaking in tongues in the other room. Yakadaga, Eseke, one said, Lord, we love you. One person said, Lord, with our desire, we love you. Nothing can change this cause. As they were speaking those words, this brother was in the other room. He became restless. Hey, by the time he removed his first clothes, removed singlets, removed trousers, remaining the boxer, before the other people began to pray, hey, the brother stood up. He went from one corner to another. He was restless. He said, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. The woman with him said, Oga, come now. Are you not doing it again? The boy said, woman, you won't understand. Hey, he was restless. The other three prayer warriors were blasting in tongues. They said, Lord, we love you. We adore your presence. Yagaba shakato mahuria. As they were praying, this other brother was in this room. He was restless. He put on his trouser. Hey, he put on his singlet. He put on his clothes. The prostitute was surprised, looking at him. The brother opened the door and ran out at the door and banged at the door of the prayer warriors. As he was knocking the open door, he jumped into the house and fell down. He began to weep. He said, oh, I don't belong in that other room. This is where I belong. He said, I don't belong in that room of prostitution. I belong in the room of prayer. The other two brothers were surprised. They said, what happened? He explained to them that I was once a prayer warrior, but condition made me denounce my faith. But I came tonight to sleep with a sex worker. When I heard your voice of reconciliation, and I could no longer stand it, I have a voice in my spirit that God still loves me, and I came here today to get another fire of revival. He cried, and they prayed for him, and he was revived. Hey, you are my longing. I cannot trade you for gold. I cannot trade you for silver. Lord, I cannot trade you for what the world brings. I cannot trade you for treasures. You are all I have. Zekete, memaspi. Olomo shagayaga. That brother wept. He said, oh Lord, help me. Open your Bible to the book of Psalm. Laba labash. That prayer warrior prayed and said, Lord, I long for you. In the book of Psalm 33. Lift your Bible in Psalm 33. Let's see what the Bible is talking about. That unquenchable longing. In the next 20 minutes, we are done with this ministration. Our time is down. Psalm 33. I'll read you verse 13. Verse 13. Now listen carefully in verse 13. The Bible says, in Psalm 33 verse 13, let me show you something. The Lord looketh from heaven, he beholdeth all the sons of men. God looked from heaven, and he beholds all the sons of men. So as you are watching me, God is seeing you. He's hearing your longing. Whatever you desire in life, God is just looking at you. When you choose the perishable things, the perishable longings, God is watching you. He said, God beholded from heaven, and he seeth everything you desire. Then in Exodus 33, and in verse 13, the Bible says, now therefore I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation belongs to you. And in verse 15 he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. Moses knew that there is something with God's presence. Moses had Israel with him. God even promised to give him an angel to go with him. Do you know what it means for God to promise you an angel to go with you? God promised Moses an angel. God promised them the land that flowed with milk and honey. God promised Israel so many things. But Moses said to God, I have seen all these things you promised us. I have seen the land. I know we will get there. I have heard about the angelic presence. That is very good. But he said, all these things are giving me, I am not okay with it. It cannot quench my desire. There is something I desire from you, and that is your presence. Moses said, the only thing that will quench this thirst now is if I find grace in your sight. Let your presence always go with us. Someone else would have taken the angelic presence. Someone else would have preferred the land of milk and honey. Someone else have prevailed Israel. But Moses said, when you combine all these things together, oh Lord, all I desire in this life is your presence. Never take your presence away from me. I love your presence. Moses had this unquenchable desire of God's presence in him. Let me tell you, no matter what you have in life, never you trade the presence of God for good. Never you trade his presence for touch and follow or for charm. Never trade the presence of God for political office or for marriage. Then because of one or two things, you now trade his presence for something. No, never you trade God's presence for anything. Moses said, if you will not go with me, don't let us kill us. Because the longing and the love I have for your presence cannot be bought over. It cannot be substituted for anything. Lekabu sabayandash. Regadagadagadagadash. Rekabababash. Oh, Lord. I am praying. May I not have anything in life that will be equivalent to your presence, Lord. May I not have anything in life that can remove your presence and replace. Oh, no. Oh, no. You are all I know. Your presence is all I ever wanted. May I not trade gold. May I not come to that level in life. May I not have that riches in life. May I never come to that level of my life where I can substitute and trade your presence for anything. For children, for family, for wife, for work, for money, for salary. No. Your presence is this grace in me, contentment. Your presence creates in me satisfaction. Nothing else could except your presence. Your presence gives me a longing. It gives me a fulfillment. Even when I don't have money, but if I can sense your presence around me, I'm okay. Ragama janama. Lose kabaya dayadaya. Lekodogodo shamayama. Libagabarabat. I don't know how many people that desire the unquenchable, the undeniable, the unstoppable, the indefatigable presence of God. I don't know who wants God to shine his presence around him every day, every night. You want his presence by all means. You cannot trade it for gold. It is like heaven on earth to you. You have got something more than treasure when you have God's presence. Let me tell you, one of the bad things, Bible says, one of the worst things that could happen to a man, one of the bad news you could ever hear in this life is to hear that God's presence have left you. But I pray for you, may his presence always be with you. I speak every one of you listening, receive his presence, receive his presence. God bless all of you that work this morning. Never you trade God's presence for anything. Never you trade his presence for anything. In the morning, the night, in the day, as you are moving, as you are walking, always desire his presence. And as you ask him for his presence, you are secured. You are secured. His presence gives confidence. God's presence gives this, that is this satisfaction that comes with presence. That is this contentment that comes with God's presence. Even when the whole world is against you, even when everyone is against you, if you have God's presence, it's enough. But when you have the whole world with you and you lack God's presence, you're alone. God's presence is majority. God's presence is a majority. When the presence of God is with you, no man can destroy you. No poison can work in your life. That is the presence of God in your life. And I speak over all of you. May His presence always be with you. His presence abide with you in the morning, in the night, every now and then. May you never come. Listen. Bible says when Israel had the bad news, what was the bad news? God announced that my presence will no longer go with you. The moment God announced the withdrawal of His presence from Israel, God Bible called it a bad news. He said when Israel had this bad news, that the presence of God had been withdrawn, all of them fell on their face and cried. Most of you thought that bad news is when you lose somebody, when you lose someone close to you. It's also a bad news, but a lower kind of it. Some thought that bad news is when you lose money. He said, what a bad news. I had a bad news. I just failed the exam. I just didn't know. The worst bad news, the senior bad news, the baddest news ever, the worst news a man can receive in his life is for the presence of God to leave him. Bible said, when Israel heard that God's presence had been withdrawn, when they had that bad news, all of them put on sackcloth and they cried because they know they are gone. They are finished without God's presence. Without God's presence, you are vulnerable. You are a prey. Without God's presence, you are a prey to your predators. They can eat you anytime. Without God's presence, anything could happen to you. But when you are enveloped in the presence of the Almighty, then you walk upon the wings of the morning. Hey, Bible said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Any tongue that is against you in judgment, you condemn them because you have the artifacts of God's presence around you. He said, you walk upon scorpions, upon snakes. Even though you eat deadly poison, they will not hurt you because you enjoy the security of God's presence. Whenever you pray, make sure you ask God for His presence to be with you. God's presence is more than heaven. God's presence is what makes a Christian. The difference between a church and a beer parlor, the difference between a church and a football